Testimony, 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 test Fantastic. You'd like to come this way? please, during the cutting of the cake, allow the accredited photographers and cameramen to take the best position. So all of you that are non-accredited, okay? So cutting of the cake.
Hello, hello, hello. Hello, everybody. May I have your attention, please? Can you turn around and look at this cake? Can you tell me if it's beautiful or not? Is it beautiful?
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, before we go into the cutting of the cake, I just want to express some thoughts about why we have a wedding cake at weddings. I mean, you know that the classical British meal, it's a British thing, will not be complete without a cake. And as I was thinking of it, I'm just saying, is it just because it's British? Is it just because it's a cake? Definitely, as I looked at it, I felt that God was speaking to us even through this cake. And I want to share my thoughts with you. I'm a baker myself, and I think I've baked Baba's several cakes. I'm also Baba's God's mother. My name also is Abimbola. So I guess when Baba couldn't find a Funke as his mom, he decided to marry another bimbo, who is his godmother. So we thank God for that. Okay, when you want to bake a cake, there are like 7 steps. And I feel in each one of those steps, the Lord is saying something about marriage. First of all, is the blending of the butter and the sugar. 2 lives coming together. And God is about to do something wonderful in their lives. Then you have the breaking of the eggs. So it means that each of them, in their own way, before God, have got to be broken. God is going to break them from being just individuals to become one. Then you have the whisking of the egg, when God begins to prune them and prune them into how he wants them to be. Then you have the sifting of the flour. And this has also got to be with a process where God takes them through. He'll be sifting their lives and taking out the shaft from what he wants to make that is beautiful. Then comes all the blending of the ingredients together. You have the almonds, you have the flour, the butter, and everything. That's when both of them discover that they have now started forming as one. They begin to perform as one when they've been all mixed together by the grace of God. Then baking, when God, you put the cake into the oven, it goes through the fire. God is going to cement them as one in his love by the power of the Holy Ghost. And by the power of the Holy Ghost working in their life, God begins to make something new in their lives. Then comes the icing. This is really the work of the Lord. When God has taken them, the Holy Spirit is working in their lives. They are imbibing his word and blending as one. They begin to produce something beautiful, something as beautiful as this cake. And the cherries on top of the cake, that definitely speaks of their children. And they will be fruitful in Jesus' name. Everybody say amen, amen. Okay, so for me, this is what a wedding cake represents. The process in which God is going to take them throughout their lives. They'll begin to find times when God is whisking them, God is sifting them, they are being blended together, they are being whisked. Let them remember that their wedding cake should be speaking to them about the work of the grace of God and the Holy Spirit in their lives. So we're not going on to the process of actually cutting the cake. Ladies and gentlemen, may I request you to be quiet, please? Quiet, please, because they're now going to cut the cake. I'm going to call, please listen to when you're going to cut the cake. I'm going to call God the Father, God the Son, and you're going to hear God the Holy Spirit. But it will not be the name of the Holy Spirit that you are used to, and what you know. So watch out. I'm going to say several things, but when you hear God the Father, God the Son, okay, let me make it easier for you. When I say God the Father, God the Son, and God the Paraclete, then you cut it, okay? So, God the Father, God the Son, God Emmanuel. No? God the Father, God the Son, Jehovah Jireh. God the Father, God the Son, God Jehovah Nissi, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Paraclete. Please clap for them. Once again, may I have your attention? Abby is going to perform her first public duty, and that is in feeding her husband. So we're going to watch her. Maybe she needs to come to where the camera is. Yeah. And it's up to you. And we're going to watch her feed her husband. Okay. All right, Joe.
You are single and ready.